In this problem, we have a heavy beam suspended horizontally with a cable at one end, and the cable is not attached all the way to the very end. It's attached to a spot here 2.5 meters from the left end, and then the beam is hooked up to a hinge at the left end. And one of our questions is to find the tension in the cable, but another one of our questions is to find the force exerted by the hinge. And before I get started doing any of the math, I wanted to figure out qualitatively which way does that force point. So we use static equilibrium reasoning for this. I know that the sum of all the forces in the x direction must equal zero. If that wasn't true, the rod would take off accelerating horizontally, but it's stationary, right? So I see the tension force has a leftward component to it, and that means that the force exerted by the hinge must have a rightward component to it in order to cancel that out. So I'm just going to go ahead and draw that component in real quick, and I'll call that hinge force x. All right, then for my next piece of reasoning, I'm going to have to get the force of gravity in here on the center of mass of my beam. And I have options here for how to do this reasoning, but what I'm going to do is look at the rotation axis located at the connection point of the cable. And the torque exerted by the tension there is zero. So all I have to think about is the hinge force and the force of gravity. So what I'm going to use here is the fact that the sum of all of the torques must be zero about any rotation axis I want, because this thing has no rotational acceleration around any point. So I chose my rotation axis right here, and I can see that gravity is exerting a counterclockwise torque with respect to that axis, which means the hinge must be exerting a clockwise torque with respect to that axis. And the x component has nothing to do with that. That exerts no torque at all. But what it means is that my y component of the hinge force must point up. And I called that FHY. So then I can put together those two components of the hinge force and show it now as a vector, something like this. And although I didn't state it clearly in the question, my goal here is to find the magnitude and the direction of this hinge force. In other words, I want to express it in polar form. All right, so what I'm going to do is take the actual hinge as the rotation axis for the first part of my calculation, and that's where I'm trying to find the tension. And I'm going to call that rotation axis number one. And I'm going to look at the sum of the torques around that rotation axis. So the counterclockwise and clockwise torques must be equal. And with respect to that axis, gravity is exerting a clockwise torque, and that's going to be mg times the length of the lever arm. Well, gravity acts at the center of mass, so that's at the 1.5 meter mark. And then my counterclockwise torque is exerted by the tension in the cable, and it's just the perpendicular component of that, so it's going to be a t sine 25 multiplied by the distance to the rotation axis, which is 2.5 meters. So plugging in mg, that's 120 times 9.8 times 1.5. And crunching it all in my calculator, I get 1,670 newtons, just keeping three sig figs there. So what about the hinge force? What I'm going to do is go after this component by component. So first off, remember the x component of the hinge force must be exactly canceling the x component of the tension pulling to the left. And so that's a quick one. I can write the x component of the hinge force, just the magnitude of it here is going to be t cosine 25. That's 1670 cosine 25 degrees. And I've got one component of the hinge force. That's 1513 newtons, just keeping an extra digit because I'm not done getting the polar form of this thing yet. What about the y component? So the way I'm going to go after this is by using the fact that the sum of all the forces in the y direction must be zero. So I have two upward forces. There's the upward component exerted by the hinge, and there's the upward component of the tension. And then those two things have to be equal in magnitude to the downward force exerted by gravity. So I have the y component of the hinge force plus a t sine 25 is equal to mg. And I'll go ahead and solve for FHY. That's mg minus t sine 25, and I'll put some numbers in there. That's 120 times 9.8 minus 1670 sine 25. And I come out with a y component of my hinge force equal to 470 newtons. And I still need to find the polar form of the hinge force. So now I'm going to take these two components and smash them together in the standard way. All right, there's my standard picture of adding the vector components vectorially, so head to tail, to build a right triangle. And then I'll get the magnitude of the hinge force using the Pythagorean theorem. So that's the square root of the sum of the squares. 1513 squared plus 470 squared. And when I smash these together, I get 1,584 newtons. And to three sig figs, I guess, 1,580. That's slightly different than the answer I got earlier today. And it's just because I did a little more rounding along the way. Then finally, we'll get the angle. And that's the angle whose tangent is 470 over 1513. So that's approximately 17.3 degrees. So I'll leave this to you, but suppose you wanted to find some kind of independent check on your work here. What I would suggest is you create a third rotation axis right at the center of mass and make sure the clockwise torque exerted by the hinge force gives you exactly the same number as the counterclockwise torque exerted by the cable. And then you can be 100% certain you've got all the numbers right.